Tough choices will have to be made. That's the warning for the New South Wales Treasurer about the September budget. Here's Kenny Heatley.
New South Wales is facing a debt blowout crisis. A big part of it has to do with massive spending undertaken by the previous government to bring New South Wales out of the COVID pandemic.
So what we're seeing from Labor is now a string of broken promises.
Sky-high inflation is not just hitting households, but Australia's largest economy.
I have to give people of New South Wales a very clear warning. The state's finances are facing severe challenges. There are serious decisions ahead, and there are tough choices to be made.
What exactly those tough choices are and how they will impact household budgets remain the subject of an expenditure review to be laid out in September's budget.
I want to be upfront with the fact that returning the budget to surplus is very, very difficult.
As economic activity slows, New South Wales is also teetering on the brink of a recession in the coming financial year. Daniel Mookie says his government needs to help bring down inflation so the burden is not entirely on households. That means reducing spending.
We will look to make savings in areas that do not have impacts on families.
But when asked if any election promises will be broken...
No.
Servicing the state's debt will also increase. Interest repayments are expected to blow out from $2.5 billion in 2021-22 to $7 billion 4 years later. Despite the dire outlook for the state's finances, the government is pushing ahead with cost of living relief, like the $60 per week toll cap and the $500 energy rebate starting in July.
With the highest inflation for 40 years, rising interest rates, rising rents, power prices, grocery prices, this government must support hardworking families and must maintain cost of living measures. Instead, what's been happening today is this government softening us up for what could be very severe cuts.
Kenny Heatley, Sky News, Sydney.